Hello guys, this is Revan from Digi Integrity. Welcome to Tech News episode 26. Action COVID-19 team, which was founded last year by various founders, leaders and venture capitalists from India's startup ecosystem. They plan to raise a 500 crore fund over the next 2 years to back solutions for societal problem across education, healthcare, environment and women's participation in the workforce. Reliance Foundation's Nita Mukesh Ambani has launched a social media platform called Her Circle on the occasion of International Women's Day. A new initiative aims to fuel women empowerment with modern digital tools. Launching for Indian women but extending its services to all women overseas, Her Circle will provide the ladies a joyful and safe space for interaction, engagement, collaboration and mutual support. FastTrack announced 3 new products offering under FastTrack Reflex portfolio. FastTrack Reflex 3.0, FastTrack Reflex 2C Pay and FastTrack Reflex Tunes, which marks a brand entry into the hearable segments. This product available in FastTrack stores and FastTrack.in. Google recently revealed that it is going to stop targeting online ads based on users' browser history. The company also said that it won't be building any tools that can keep track to specific user data across products. And company also said that keeping the internet open and accessible for everyone requires all of us to do more to protect privacy. And that means end to not only third-party cookies but also any technology used to tracking individual people as they browse the web. PhonePe is planning to increase female employees in leadership roles to 25% by this December. Amazon India's hyperlocal program for offline retailers and neighborhood stores to cater to nearby customers has scaled to over 50,000 sellers from 450 cities in less than 1 year of launch. According to the company's statement on Sunday, launched in April 2020, local shops on Amazon had more than 20,000 sellers participate in Amazon.in's Great Indian Festival hosted in October 2020. Kiro's Food, a maker of diabetic snacks, planned to raise $4 million in next 2 years to expand its reach to top 30 cities in India in an effort to tap the country's $600 diabetic food market. The company is backed by Integrated Incubator Venture Catalyst, hopes to achieve Rs. 200 crore sales by 2025, when India is expected to have more than 15 crore diabetic people. Driverless personal rapid transport or pod taxi could be considered for last mile connectivity of passengers commuting to and from the upcoming Noida International Airport. The iTech pod taxis, which are used in several countries, are cost effective, pro-environment and convenient. Venture capital fund Bloom Ventures have raised around 350 crores for a new secondary fund which it has launched with Avendus Capital. This vehicle will invest in the fund's large portfolio companies and continue to support them in a longer period. Dream Sports, which is currently executing a secondary sale of shares that will value the online fantasy sport platform at $4 billion, won't raise any fresh capital from Chinese investors in the future. It is said by the founder and chief executive officer of Dream Sports. Tencent Holding Limited, a Chinese multinational that owns a hugely popular messaging app WeChat, owns a less than 10% of Dream Sports. Ola is seeking to transform itself from being a mobility service provider to a player in the low-cost electric vehicle market, globally modeling itself from Elon Musk's Tesla. The Bengaluru-based riding-hailing company wants to own the entire value chain from engineering, manufacturing and a sale of electric vehicle, beginning with electric scooters as early as the middle of this year, then on a building of small electric cars in the near future. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.